Hello, my name is Mary Jean, and I'm from Atlanta. In 1973, I had an abortion. The airline I worked for required that all flight attendants who became pregnant must retire. Abortion seemed like the only means of my survival. I was living in a new city, abandoned by the father and afraid to go home of origin. The fear, guilt, and shame of becoming pregnant was more than I could live with. I flew to Los Angeles. A relative took me to a Planned Parenthood office. I was referred to one of their clinics. I was given anesthesia before the procedure. I never saw the doctor, nor did I have any idea what was going to happen to me. I remember the nurse wheeling me in, and I remember begging God to forgive me because I had no other choice. While in recovery, I was told that I had been screaming and asking God to forgive me. I later learned that I had had a DNC because I had scars and adhesions that would have prevented me from becoming pregnant again. Immediately after the abortion, I felt a sense of relief. However, inside, I felt like a person made of stone. All my feelings shut down except for extreme anger, but I had to shove that down to just survive and go back to living as if nothing happened. Later, I married, had a lovely home, and was blessed with three beautiful, healthy children. However, on the inside, I was miserable. I began suffering from severe depression, anorexia, sexual frigidity, and lack of any emotional intimacy with my husband, or and a lack of emotional bonding with my children. I felt like such a failure as a mother, although that I had just went through the motions and did what I thought was best for them. After suffering in silence for 30 years, I knew it was time to get help. I could no longer bear the emotional pain that I had been carrying for so many years. In 1999, I became involved in Bible study and the Rachel's Vineyard Retreat through the PATH Ministry in Atlanta. I sincerely believe that God has forgiven me and I have forgiven myself. The truth about the pain, guilt, grief, and suffering of those who had an abortion has to be told. The truth about the effects of abortion on relationships, families, and community needs to be exposed. This is why I am silent no more.